Hi guys, and welcome to this new Arabic lesson with me, Maha. Today I'm going to teach you the five different ways to say no or to negate any sentence in Arabic. Before we start, I want to make sure you are a subscriber to this channel. Please subscribe and turn on the notification bell. If you're interested in more Arab related content, you can follow me on Instagram at Maha Yaqub and on my Facebook page at Learn Arabic with Maha, one word only. Without further ado, let's begin with the lesson. This is something that I've been asked 1,000 times. It's very difficult, guys, to negate a sentence in Arabic. There are 5 different ways. There's a way to say I didn't eat. There's a way to say I don't eat. There's a way to say I will not eat. There's a way to say I am not an Arab. There's a way to say I'm not a girl. There are 5 different ways. It depends on which grammar you're talking about in order to say simply la, which means no. We can't use la for everything. I'm going to teach you in this lesson how to negate anything in Arabic. Let's begin. So let's start with the most difficult one, okay? The most difficult one is laysa. Laysa. Laysa, it means not, okay? But what does it negate? Does it say I did not eat? Can I say laysa akaltu? I ate. I did not eat. Unfortunately not. Laysa, okay, it means not. But it only negates 2 things: verb to be or adjectives. Alright, let's imagine he is an Arab. If he's an Arab, I say huwa arabi. That's the sentence. Huwa arabi. He's not an Arab. I have to say huwa laysa arabi. I'm negating the adjective arabi. He's not an Arab. Huwa laysa arabi. In this case, I'm negating the verb to be. I'm saying he's not. Huwa laysa arabi. And I can also be negating the adjective itself. I'm negating the fact that he's an Arab. Arab is an adjective here, not a noun. So huwa laysa arabi. I'm laysa the arabi. I'm negating the fact that he's an Arab, which is the adjective. So this is one example. Huwa arabi. Huwa laysa arabi. Let's imagine he is not Muhammad. Let's say he's Muhammad. Huwa Muhammad. I think you know that the verb to be in Arabic doesn't exist. We just say he, Muhammad, that means he's Muhammad. So huwa Muhammad, he is Muhammad. But I want to tell you, no, he's not Muhammad, he's Yusuf. Huwa laysa Muhammad. You see, we added laysa. Huwa laysa Muhammad. What am I negating here? Am I negating an adjective? Am I saying he's not beautiful? No, I'm saying he's not the noun. He's not Muhammad. So you see, this is a proof that laysa works for both negating nouns, negating adjectives. He is beautiful, we say huwa jamil. He's not beautiful. Huwa laysa jamil. He's not beautiful. Huwa laysa, then the adjective. This means he's not the adjective. All right, up until now, I think you understood how to negate the verb to be and how to negate an adjective in Arabic. Unfortunately, before I move on to the next 4 ways to negate in Arabic, I want to tell you that this laysa, maybe you guessed from the examples that I gave you, it only functions with he. Why? This laysa should be conjugated with the person we're talking about. If it's she, it doesn't stay laysa, it gets conjugated like a normal verb, guys. This is the crazy thing about negating adjectives and verbs to be, that the participle of negation, the thing that should only mean no, is negated, is conjugated. No he, no she, no they. That's the meaning. But I'm not going to complicate your lives today. I'm going just to show you the different ways to negate different aspects of the Arabic grammar. And then I will go more in detail to conjugate all the laysa for you. Up until now, we said, if I want to say he is not either an adjective or a noun, I simply say laysa. So laysa is our participle that helps us negate adjectives and nouns. All right, let's switch now to only adjectives. There's one other way if I want only to negate adjectives, which is the word غير. This word here, غير, it means not, then the adjective, okay? For example, if I want to say I'm not an Arab, I can say أنا غير عربية. I'm not Arabiya. If I was a male and I'm not tall, I would say أنا غير طويل. I'm not tall. Why did I give you the possibility of me being a male? Because I want to show you here, and alhamdulillah, finally, that the word غير doesn't change with the number or the gender. It stays غير. Unlike ليس that we learned in the first way to negate, the word غير negates any adjective, guys. Either if it's male or female or plural, it doesn't matter. غير stays غير. For example, he's not fat. هو غير ثمين. She's not fat. هي غير ثمينة. غير stays غير. They are not fat or they are not Arab. All of them. هم غير عرب. غير negates adjectives. Arab in this case are adjectives, not nouns. Let's imagine he is hungry. هو جائع. هو is not hungry. هو غير جائع. Can we do it? هو ليس جائع. Does it work with the first one that we learned? Yes, because we said the first one can work with both nouns and adjectives. The second one, which is غير, works specifically with adjectives. All right? غير negates adjectives. Whatever adjective there is, it stays غير. The third way to negate things is when we want to negate a past tense verb, guys. If I want to say, I didn't eat, I didn't study, I didn't go, what happens? Do I say غير? Do I say ليس? No, there is another way to negate past tense verbs. So now we're switching from adjectives and nouns into verbs. So to negate a past tense verb, we have a way. To negate a present tense, we have a way. And to negate a future tense verb, we have another way. That's why we have total 5 ways. One for nouns and adjectives. One to negate solo adjectives, only adjectives. One for past tense, one for present tense, and one for future tense. 5 ways to simply say no. Let's go now to number 3, which I told you. Let's learn how to say I didn't in the past. I, not the verb. So let's imagine I want to say I studied. I studied, we say أنا درست. أنا درست. درست اللغة العربية. I studied Arabic language. If I want to say I didn't درست. درست stays درست. Studied. And I insert what? Number 3, which is ما. You simply say ما before the verb conjugated, and then you change the whole sense of the language of the sentence. It becomes negative. أنا درست, I studied. أنا ما درست, I didn't study. درست, ما درست. Let's imagine you ate the كعكة, the cake. أنت أكلت الكعكة. You ate the كعكة. أنت أكلت الكعكة. You didn't eat the كعكة. أنت ما أكلت الكعكة. You answered ما before the verb, which is already conjugated. Remember, the verb should stay conjugated. ما doesn't change. They went to school. هم ذهبوا إلى المدرسة. I want to say no, they didn't ذهبوا. What do I say? ما ذهبوا. Didn't go. This is, guys, how you translate, how you negate a past tense verb. You simply insert ma. There's another way to negate a past tense verb, which is more complicated, which is adding lam plus present tense, but I will not teach you that because it's much easier to negate it using ma and the verb itself. Ma akaltu, I didn't eat. Ma sharibtu, I didn't drink. Ma darastu, I didn't study. Now, if I want to say I don't study, the ma gets changed into the participle to negate present tense verbs. If I want to negate anything that I do in the present, or you do, or they do, anything that is in the present tense verb, we use the participle la. Simply la. You know that la means no. La also negates present tense verbs. For example, I speak. أتكلم. I speak German. أتكلم or Arabic. أتكلم العربية. I speak Arabic. أتكلم العربية. I don't speak Arabic. لا أتكلم العربية. لا أتكلم. Do I say ما أتكلم? Doesn't make any sense. I'm negating past tense verb with the present tense verb. No, I should learn the real negation. لا أتكلم. لا آكل. I don't eat. لا أشرب. I don't drink. لا أذهب. I don't go. لا أريد. I don't want. Very, very easy. Now, what happens if I want to negate a future tense? I want to say, I will not go. Not I don't go. I will not go. It's much more easier because you keep the verb the way it is in the present tense because you know in the future, I don't know if you don't know, but if you know, if you don't know, the future tense, guys, in Arabic is exactly like the present tense with the word will before it, and that's it. So instead of saying, I don't go, saying, أنا لا أذهب, I only change the participle into the future and I will keep أذهب, أذهب. أنا لن أذهب, the participle, or the connector, or the word, the helping word. لن means no. So also لن means no, but it means no in the future. أنا لن أذهب, I will not go. أنا لا أذهب, I do not go. أنا لن أذهب, I will not go. أنا لن أشرب القهوة, I will not drink coffee. أنا لا أشرب قهوة, I do not drink coffee. I don't want to say I do not, I want to say I will not. How do I change it? By changing the لا into لن. Because لن negates everything that is in the future tense. لن أذهب, لن أشرب, لن أكل, I will not eat. لن أنام باكرا, I will not sleep. لن أنام. Alright, fantastic. Now you have 5 different ways to negate anything in Arabic. And this is like a revelation to many of my students because I understand it is not that easy. It's difficult to understand what to choose to negate what. Remember, for adjectives, you are like, you have a free ticket. You use ليس with all the conjugation with ليس. I'll teach it later. Or غير, very easy. غير plus the adjective, ليس plus the adjective, it negates it. If you want to negate a noun, any noun, this is not a car, you use simply ليس. Negate it, conjugate it. I will show you later how to conjugate ليس. If you want to negate a past tense verb, you use ما. Present tense verb, you use لا. Future tense verb, you use لن. This is the 5 ways to say لا to anything باللغة العربية, in Arabic language. Now, what I want from you is I want you to create 5 sentences. 5 simple sentences. Not the ones that I told you now, of course. I want you to create from your imagination 5 sentences that negate different aspects of the Arabic grammar. I want you to send them here below. Or if you want, take a picture of your homework and tag me on Instagram or on Facebook. On Instagram, I reply more and I might end up sharing your homework. So tag me at Maha Yaqoub. I will check your homework. I will reply to it, correct it, and maybe share it. I'm really looking forward to see if you understood how negation works in Arabic. If you like this kind of lessons, please make sure to subscribe to the channel. What is missing is the conjugation of ليس, which I will make in a different lesson because it's too much and too long. So these are, guys, the 5 different ways to say no in Arabic. I hope you like this lesson. I don't want to forget to say thank you and shukran from the bottom of my heart to my patrons for their continuous support of my project. Without you, it would have been much more difficult to maintain the pace of producing new Arabic content for my YouTube channel. So thank you so much, guys. If you want to learn about my Patreon page or how to become a patron and what you get back, like what are the rewards or the perks, please visit my Patreon page. And also, I invite you to become a member of this channel. I open memberships for exclusive community only. So if you want to become a member, please check the join button and check the rewards and the perks that I am rewarding you with by becoming a member of this channel. And thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in a following Arabic lesson with Mimaha. Don't forget the homework. Bye.